Okay, so beware of the temptation of perceiving you've been unfairly treated. That's lovely. That comes from the text of course, being unfairly treated. So, you see, you don't want to... you've got to find a way not to pick up data, either from your own personal consciousness. It's victimhood, essentially. I'm a victim of how you've treated me. So being unfairly treated, or the perception, because only the limited self, the ego self, that which is in separation, can perceive oneself as being unfairly treated by, you know, I don't know, it could be like in a purchase or in a sale of goods. So problem with that is it's also a self-attack thought. And, all things are self-attack thoughts, because it doesn't matter whether it's a personal self or someone else, it's the one self. So they're all self-attacks. Whether I'm wrong or they're wrong, it's a self-attack thought. It's also perception, because, as it says later on, there's nothing to forgive. When you realize that we're all, when you realize the non-dual space of oneness within all, then it's recognized there is no me and you. So there is nothing to forgive at that level. However, from the level of separation, when I'm in my ego and I think I am this body, I'm this self, and I just tried to sell you some goods and you haven't paid me the money, so I feel unfairly treated. Basically, what that's doing is it's doing several things actually for me. Harboring grievance and anger is a vibration and doesn't allow the light of miracles into the interaction. Also, certain things can happen. Sometimes you're going to pray and pray for the person and they're going to change and they're going to give you the money back, and sometimes they're not. But it doesn't really matter, because sometimes the lesson is to forgive and to let it go and not track that. And sometimes the lesson, even if you don't get it back, you're not necessarily praying for the Holy Spirit to make them give you the money, but sometimes they will, because sometimes we're all one. So sometimes when you meet that love and forgiveness, a miracle can happen sometimes. But you've got to understand that when you indulge in the victim story or the grievance against another individual, you're perpetuating that vibration, that perception. So either one is doing, God is love and which I forgive, which is the idea there's a separate me and there's a God and there's another. So there's three parties involved, and you're just calling God's love for you to forgive the other and call on that power, and the Holy Spirit intercedes. And then you see it differently and you let it go. So you're no longer holding that data in the present. It's cleared that belief system, that judgment is gone, and that perception, now you go more into vision rather than being in ego perception, because in true vision, actually there's nothing to forgive in true vision. So there is, it's just the temptation to hold on to victimhood. Now, or you could just pray for a miracle to see it differently. You know, like the Holy Spirit said, well, they're ignorant. Or you may get, if you go into past lives and karmic research, you'll know that, from a past lifetime, you didn't give them, they sold you something and you didn't pay them. So they're back. They're back to do the same deed unto you, and you just got to forgive them. As Hawkins would say, just laugh and say that pays that debt off, so sometimes, but you can't track what you don't give meaning to. So the temptation is then money is meaningful, and holding judgment is meaningful. Also, so you just got to let it go. The more advanced you go, you might have a commitment to unconditional love. So that's then a temptation to not love. Everyone's lovable unless you don't pay me money back for my goods. And that's the one thing that's unforgivable and unlovable. So you gotta, if you hold the love, but if you do hold the love and let it go, you'll have a miracle in perception, you'll have a shift. It's like the Holy Spirit will just sort of give you a different way of seeing the situation. Like sometimes for myself, it's like, well, you know, I've probably like been quite dishonest around money. This person is, so it's an opportunity for me to forgive myself, isn't it, really? Like all those times I didn't pay the fair amount, or I tried to get more than my dues worth, or you know, I stole. Now, if I can forgive you, I'm forgiving myself. So it's an opportunity for me to forgive myself. So there's like a, so that's a blessing, isn't it? It's like an assignment to forgive myself for the things I've done to others. So that's the Lord's prayer, isn't it? Forgive them, forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Yes. So that's the Lord's Prayer. So it's, you know, anything that creates judgment or self-attack is perception, because you're in your limited self. And in the infinite self, where there's oneness, then there cannot be anything to forgive. And it's realized that actually in the infinite self, there's nothing to fear, and that actually God is the source. When you're connected to the infinite is the source of all security, not whether they pay you back the money. So funny enough, it's an invitation to fear, isn't it, really? Well, you haven't paid me for my, what would I sell on eBay? I don't know what sell. I'm trying to sell, actually, a photo of what's her name? Princess, she was Princess Leia, no, Carrie Fisher. I might have to try and sell my photo of her on, but you know, if I sent the photo and they didn't send me the money back, then it's a thing of, actually for me to hold on to anger and judgment would mean I would tune into that vibration, I'd have more stuff taken away from me. Because I'm now like, I'm angry at everyone. So that vibration means I'll be, you know, I'll have more stuff taken away from me. Because fear doesn't support life. Because those high vibrations of spirit actually are the things that bring money and abundance to you. Not being in fear and holding judgment and anger against others. So actually it's holding on to the illusion, the perception that if I'm angry at people and I shout at them and tell them to give me my money, that would mean I'd be more secure. So it's based on fear and that perception. But actually being in peace and abundance, you know, and knowing that God is my source, that vibration of oneness is my source, that actually brings money and all my needs my way. So then I would just say, because that's coming from my fear-based belief that if I try and grab money off people, if I think I've been perceived, but that's not the source of my security. That's fear and just being angry at you and just sort of shaking my fist. So that means I'll probably lose more and more money. So if I can forgive and go to that vibration is the thing that attracts more and more money coming my way, not me being angry because you didn't give me money for my photo I just sold you. So those are just different ways to see it, but it is all perception. Ultimately, if you go to oneness, there is nothing to forgive. And when you go into those high spiritual states, it's very hard to hold on to attack. Everything just passes through you like water. It's just too difficult to hold on to resentments when you're fully spiritual. So you're in the divine flow of life. You don't really hold on to data. And it's a virtuous circle. So these are temptations. So basically anyone doing spiritual work is having things in the world which are invitations to hook in, you know. Like you can let go of, I don't know, like people who don't wash their hands, but if someone doesn't pay you money, you can't let that go. So that's what you're going to be faced with until you can let that go. So it's you're clearing that data from you. So I empathize with that thing. Money is... You know, is money the source of security, or is my divine connection to the infinite my source of security? So there's the temptation, there's the collective thing, like money is the source of my security. If you take my money, you're taking my security. But is money the higher power? Is money how many banknotes I've got, the thing that keeps me safe? Or is it me being in that vibration that keeps me safe? And actually holding on to anger and fear is a thing. In the 12 steps we say, like, we've got step one for anyone from 12 steps, like, I'm powerless, I'm unmanageable. Unmanageability is because I'm not in the divine field. It's because I'm in fear and control.